Held in, now to Jackman. Jackman's drive and a save by Mrazek. But he couldn't get into the glove. Now Piranha, backhand feet in front. This is the Blues' best pressure by far tonight. And then Berglund hit back on the goal. And then Perron got a slash in the gut from Franzen. Perron hit Franzen from behind, and then he turned around and he just slashed Perron right in the top of the leg or the midsection.
The hardest working shift of the game for the Blues. And David Perron, while Franzen was facing the board, David Perron just nudged him into the glass, and Franzen turned around and got him with the tip of his stick right in the midsection. Franzen going off. There's the play here. You see the little nudge there from behind. And then there.
Oh!
Right in the midsection. CSI St. Louis might find some remnants on the tip of that blade.
Well, Franzen has gone to the Red Wing dressing room. Franzen gets a game, five in a game. Perron gets the boarding minor.
So virtually the Blues are going to be on the power play for the last 5 minutes of this game. No, it's the last three of the five. No, I forgot about the two.
Yep. But that's correct. So three full minutes.
Yep.
Funnier things have happened in this game of hockey.
Especially with the way the Red Wings kill penalties and the way the Blues play the power play, Banger.
Well, the Blues really got back to just putting on their work helmets there last week. Last period shift, excuse me. But we'll go back to the last game in Detroit, and that was that hit, of course, on David Backes that ends up being a five-minute major. And a game misconduct, gone for the game, rescinded by the NHL. But now we've got a 7:22 left, and Franzen is gone for the game.
By the way, Backes did send a text message to Huskins after the game to see how he was. Of course, Huskins played for the Blues a year ago as a good man and
one of the great pros.
So we go 4-on-4 for 2 minutes. Here's Quincy.